I actually thought let's do a quick get ready with me. Let's do a simple look. Yeah. Beauties and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 43 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today I thought let's do a chatty get ready with me and try to be as chatty as possible. I have here in front of me, I'm going to be all over the place, just so you know. I have here two Jeffree Star palettes, the Alien palette and the Mini Breaker. I actually thought it would be fitting because I'm going to talk about Jeffree Star and why I did not get the last release. That is basically what I wanted to do. So, as you see, I have staining. A lot of staining, actually. That is from the Warrior 3 by Juvia's Place. So, let me get my MAC paint pot and hope it covers what I wanted to cover. So, yeah. These two are actually... Where's my brush? Oh, there. These two palettes are actually my favorite Jeffree Star palettes that I have here, and I have four. I have these two, I have the Big Breaker, and I have the Blue Blood. And I am not getting the Jeffree Star Shane release. And that may be shocking to some of you, it may not be shocking to others, but let me explain why I am not going to get this release from Jeffree Star. First off, let me just say that I think it is brilliant how they marketed it with the Shane documentary, Jeffree Star documentary. I really like to watch that because it's fascinating to see the people behind the brand. It's fascinating to see how a release or a palette like this is made, you know, and what yeah, everything that surrounds it. I was being sucked into the hype, as I think a lot of people are, which is a brilliant marketing tool. Just doesn't really matter how you look at it, it's just brilliant, you know. I like the Jeffree Star formula, but to be quite fair, I have other formulas that I like more. So what draws me in with Jeffree Star Cosmetics is the fact that Jeffree has a kind of a weird eye for color combinations, which I love because I also have that. That is one of the reasons that I love the Alien palette so much. And that one was the first palette that I really saw by Jeffree Star Cosmetics. I know he had the Blue Blood as well, but when I started with makeup, the first big release that I saw from Jeffree Star was the Alien palette. I fell in love instantly, but it's very expensive, and I was just starting my channel then, and that palette was on my wish list for so long that I think half a year after it had released, I finally got it on sale, and I was so happy, and it is still one of my favorite Jeffree Star palettes. Then we got the Blue Blood release, and with the Blue Blood release, I got sucked in. Is it a bad quality? No, it's not a bad quality. It's a good quality. However, the color story is not really something that I grab a lot. After I did my videos, I actually didn't grab it since. And it's a very expensive, nice looking jewelry box, basically. I just, you know, I got sucked in by the hype. Fortunately for me, when I ordered the Blue Blood here at a Dutch site, I had it next day. So that was good because my video on the Blue Blood was one of the first ones that went up that was not PR. So yeah, there was that. And I was really fortunate to have that. And I did have some traction from that, but you know, I was so tiny then that it did not really matter. I'm still tiny, but a lot bigger than I was then. So yeah, then came the next release, which was the Breaker. The Big Breaker and the Mini Breaker. The Big Breaker, color story wise, is more up my alley. So when I saw it first, and all... Remember that there is a lot of hype around every Jeffree Star release. Always. It's so hyped up. People are talking about it. The whole internet is a buzz. And everyone wants it. And You know, so I also thought that I need to want it. And yeah, again, I got a little bit sucked in. However, this time it was more along the lines of my color story. Because I like bright colors, especially in summer. It was a brilliant summer release. Let's go to phone home. I'm still in the alien palette. I don't know what I'm doing. I'm just putting eyeshadows on. Oh, that's such a pretty color. So yeah, again, I ordered it, or I wanted to order it. However, the site that I wanted to order it from, that I actually ordered the blue blood from, did not have it in stock. It was, how do you call it? Pre-order. And they were set to have it within 1 to 2 weeks. And I was like, yeah, but that's a little bit too long. If I want to, you know, kind of have a little bit of benefit from it for my channel as well, I need to have it sooner. So I ordered it from Beauty Bay. I ordered the Big Breaker and I ordered the Mini Breaker. But I had to wait a few days for that, because Beauty Bay does not ship in the weekends. So yeah, I had to wait a few days. So I think I ordered it on Friday. I think I had it a week later or something along those lines. So when I got it, I immediately started filming with it. But if I'm being completely honest, the only one of that release that truly has my heart is the Mini Breaker. That color story is so, so me. I really, really like it. And I know some of you got the Big Breaker on my recommendation. I still stand by what I said. It's a very good quality. It's a very nice palette. I really like the color story. However, it's not a favorite. It doesn't have my heart the same way that the Alien and the Mini Breaker has. And I hope that makes sense. So I kind of had a little bit of, I got sucked in again, you know. Because if I'm being quite honest, the only palette that I really, really wanted with all my heart was the Mini Breaker. So I got sucked in with the big one again. Then this whole thing started. And I was like, okay, let's try not to get sucked in again. Let's try. Then I saw the sneak peeks and I was like, oh, but yeah, they look pretty. They look nice. I kind of like the color story. Then they kind of dropped that bright green shade. And I understand why the big palette is half neutral, half colorful. I understand that. And I agree. I had hoped though that they would do the mini conspiracy like the Mini Breaker and make that an all colorful palette. You know, that was what I was hoping for. Well, it didn't happen. Yeah, what can you do about it? It's not my palette. It's not my release. So yeah, I was like, well, let's see what happens and all that goodness. And then the palette was, I was like, I want to see the final palette before I make a decision. I had already kind of scouted out the sites that would be selling it in Europe. And one of the sites it was Beauty Bay, which would take a few days. Even if I were to pay for next day delivery, it wouldn't deliver the next day because they don't deliver in the weekends. So I was like, okay, every which way you look at it, I have to wait a few days. The palette needs to be enough for me to wait that amount of time. I need to want it enough. I hope that makes any sense. Do I want a purple or do I want a green? Or do I want a black? Huh. Let's get the gray. I'm still using the same brush. I'm using the tip. So then I saw that the makeup spot where I ordered the blue blood would have it as a pre-order again. So I was like, okay, so now I know that I really need to want the palette, because I won't have it the next day. It's just not going to happen. Then I saw the final palette and I was like, ooh, I really, really like it. When I watched the video, I was like, ooh, I like this. And oh yeah, I want to get it. I like it, I like it, I like it. And then I went online and I saw all the different pictures. And I was like, wait, you are not going to get it the next day. You are just not. So you won't be among the first to have a video up. It's just not going to happen. Do you want it enough? Because it's an expensive palette, guys. You know, are you going to use it enough? Is it worth the money for you? Quality-wise, it probably is, but is the color story enough for you as well? I'm not going to lie. If there had been a red shimmer in there, I probably would have gotten it. Because I like the color story of the palette. But I don't like it enough. You know, I have to be completely honest with myself, and I really went screening that palette. Is it something that I will get use out of? And to be quite honest with you, the answer is no. So that is why I'm not going to get it. I almost got sucked in again, and I'm very glad that I didn't. I watched Annette's video this morning, her first impression. It looks pretty. Her look is very, very pretty. The palette looks pretty. I have seen swatches of the palette as well. But no, I'm going to pass. And it's sold out anyway, so I cannot get it now. But I'm going to pass nonetheless. I'm not going to get it. If I were to get it, I'm sure that I could make gorgeous looks with it. But you know, for that price, I think it retails for, what was it, 54 euros. That's, how much is that in dollars? I think around 60, something along those lines. And to be quite honest with you, there are other things that I want. That's it. There are other things that I want more. My collection is growing, and I don't mind that, but it does mean that I kind of want to be a little bit more conscious. Yes, I think it is. What I want to bring in, because my collection is growing. I also, you know, have a lot of colors already. And to be quite honest with you, a lot of the colors that are in the palette from Shane, I have. Not all, but a lot I have. So yeah, I'm actually more interested in the one from Sample Beauty that just came out than that one, if I'm being completely honest with you. So yeah. Do I like this? I have no idea. I'm just playing. Which is also nice, you know, just to play. I also am filming more Instagram looks. Because then I just get to play. And I know a lot of people want to see new makeup, but I also kind of want to play with the makeup that I have. So there's that. And let me get my glitter primer. So I'm just grabbing my NYX glitter primer. I'm going to go to the mini breaker for the color Bite Me, which is that gorgeous shimmery purple, which stains like a mother effer, but it's very, very pretty nonetheless. I want Alien from the Alien palette, which is the gorgeous green. Oh, it's so pretty. Just on the other side of the brush. Oh! It's one of the best shimmery greens that I have. It's so gorgeous. It's so, so, so pretty. I'm just dipping into the purple shimmer and putting it on top of the greeny one. Just to mix them together a little bit. And to create some interestingness. It's not a word, but it is a word now. So yeah. I like that. I don't know if I like the mattes that I have used, but yeah, it is what it is. I have them on my face anyway. Okay, let me do that on the other eye too. And then think about what else I want to talk about, because I don't know. I want a little bit of the goldeny, I think. Yeah. I have this brush. I'm going into the color Slice, which is actually the golden shimmer from the Mini Breaker. I want it here. It's kind of looking a little bit too much like one of the looks I did recently, so I want to do something different. Oh, that's pretty. Let's kind of mix them together a bit. I also kind of don't want to get sucked into that hype anymore, you know, by buying something just because I think I want it, or because someone that I love to watch wants it, you know? I don't know. I think this is pretty. So let's go to the base now. I have here the Elf Putty Primer. Let's try that. I've used it a few times. I don't really know if I like it or not. So let's just smear it on the face. I have here my NARS foundation. Let me put it on. It's so pretty. It is unfortunately getting a little bit too dark for me. So that's very sad. But yeah. I think I can still make it work, just barely. I need to bring it down a bit though, because yeah, it's actually too dark. And I have been looking for, well, a lighter color of the NARS. It's just, yeah, it is pretty expensive. It is a very expensive foundation, but it is so, so pretty. And I don't know how this one will be in winter time, but I do know that I really, really liked it in summer because it feels so lightweight. Then again, I also really love the Clinique one that I have here, the face and body. And that one is actually a nice value because you get a lot. You know, I'm just not really impressed by the e.l.f. primer. Maybe it is because my face is too textured, I don't know. But I'm not really that impressed, guys. I have here two colors of my One Drop coverage from Catrice. I have the 010 and the 030. I'm actually right in the middle, but the one that is right in the middle, the 020, is too yellow. So I'm just going to mix one drop of each. And then whatever I have left, I'm kind of, I don't know, putting on my nose and a little bit there and a little bit there. And then just kind of, well, basically bounce everything in. Okay, so I do have to set this though, especially underneath my eyes. So let's do that with, what do I want to set it with? Let's get my hourglass because I can. Or let's get my Root Cosmetics. Let's get my Root Cosmetics for underneath the eyes. Oh, really? I put it all over my mirror, which is not a good idea. Oh, I'm going to set my face with my hourglass because, yeah. Why not? I actually always start setting my face where I'm going to use the most powder. So that is on my cheeks and temples and forehead and such. And I just press it in. See, I can never do, you know, those chatty tutorial or those chatty get ready with me's that people do where they don't talk about their makeup but just something else. I cannot do that. Oh. I always talk about how I'm doing stuff. The makeup that I'm, oh, and why I'm doing that there and all that. I don't know. Okay. So let's get you there. Let's that sit for just a second and do eyebrows. Because, yeah. I used to kind of brush my eyebrows up. But my eyebrows don't want to stay up. They are a bit rambunctious. So I just leave them where they are, basically. They just like to be horizontal. And who am I to say that they can be? Yeah, let's leave that to sit for just a little while I finish off the eyes. I'm going into area 51, which is the matte purple. Which is not my favorite purple. Just saying. I have better purples, but yeah. Which is a shame, because I really like the color of this purple. It's just not a really good purple, at least in my opinion. Okay, let's blend it a bit. I think the gray that I put down is completely lost now, but yeah, it does not really matter. Bottom. I can do a green. Let's do green, because I can. Zoom from ColourPop. That again, everyone is raving about, and I just don't find them that good, to be quite honest with you. They dry out really, really quickly. Ugh. Damn, now I kind of want to do other colors there. Of course I do. Let me get Purple Punch from the Mini Breaker, which is the darkest purple matte. I'm doing all kinds of wonky stuff. I have here a lip brush and the glitter glue. And I'm kind of going to draw a wing shape. Let's see if it will work. I'm going to go into the color Bite Me, which was the purple shimmer. I'm going to extend it. Kind of like a wing. Then I'm getting the green called Alien. I'm going to blend lightly. I'm getting a little bit of Alien on the tips. So I'm basically creating a cut crease without doing a cut crease. I kind of like that. Okay, I want that purple a little bit higher because of the way that my eye is shaped. I actually thought, let's do a quick get ready with me. Let's do a simple look. Yeah. That's what I wanted to do today, a simple look. So sorry. But yeah, I'm going to do the same on the other eye. I think something like that, but I do want that color Bite Me, that shimmery purple underneath my eyes as well. I have a tiny bit of glitter glue. I'm just going to place it underneath my eye. Then a little bit of the color Bite Me, that purple. I'm just sticking it on top. A little bit of the color Alien. I don't know what this has become, but I really do like it though. I don't really have a lot to talk about anymore, so I'm just going to finish off my face real quick. Put on liner, mascara, falsies and all that goodness, and then I will just close off the video. So yeah, I'll be right back. Well, everything is on and here is the final look. Not as simple as I had planned originally, but I like it nonetheless. I think it's very, very pretty. So yeah, the lipstick I have on is one from Carity, one of the mattes in the color whatever. The rest of the makeup will be listed down in the description box. I think that's easier. So yeah, I hope I made a bit of sense. I don't know if I did though. I don't know why, but it is very difficult for me to talk about something else while doing my makeup and then not talk about makeup and trying to stay on topic. So yeah, so again, I kind of hope I succeeded. I'm not sure though. This was it for my get ready with me talking about why I'm not getting the Jeffree Star Shane collection. I don't even know how I'm going to call it. I was planning on a simple look and this happened. Sometimes that happens a lot. I think let's do a nice and simple look. I don't know, apparently I'm not really able to do a nice and simple look, because it's usually full glam. But yeah, the earrings, I changed as well from these to these, because I actually thought that they would go nicely with the look. They are very, very cute. I made them So yeah, if you like these, follow me on Instagram, send me a DM and we can chat about it. That's it. Yeah, this is it as well for this video. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up. It will help me out tremendously. Let me know down below your opinion on the whole Jeffree Star Shane collection. Did you get it? Do you want it? You know, all that goodness and your reasoning why. I think that's it, guys. Yeah, I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening, and I hope to see you soon in my next one. Bye, guys.